work. After a few years' struggle, he gave a huge hit called Dhoni. Now, Aditya doesn't work with him, but his best friend, his childhood friend, Karan Johar, comes into the picture very strategically. He hires him, and then he shoots for this film for 3 years, and then he declares to the world that such a flop star, I can't sell the film to exhibitors. Someone who's belonging to this film industry for the last 14, 15 years, and I have started my small studio, I have also directed a film, delivered a film, released a film, I want to know how, in which circumstances, after a blockbuster delivery of a Dhoni, Karan Johar doesn't have a buyer for a film called Drive? How does that work? Let's have a conversation with exhibitors and producers. Let's have it on your show. I want to know the business mathematics and the financial mathematics of it. How? Because today, even I can release a film in 1,000 prints with whenever Corona is not there. Even somebody like me who's an upcoming studio, I have the... Karan Johar does not have the ability to release suppose it's a big disaster, but to save everybody's name and careers and, you know.
But the film was not a disaster. I'm sorry to intervene. Dhoni was not a disaster film. It was a great film, wasn't it? Wasn't it successful?
Dhoni was a big hit. It came in theatres. But a film called Drive did not come in theatres, which Karan Johar made with Sushant. He dumped it. He said, I can't sell this film with this flop star. This was the, in his created this whole business racket that he's created, which declared his films as hit. And big films like even Manikarnika and Chichore and Dhoni are declared semi-hits. So his whole circle started to print and, you know, spread these rumors that Sushant is finished. Now this is on public domain. You can see that this film, Drive, was not released, and only media reports that Sushant is a flop actor, so Karan Johar is not finding a buyer for his film. And then he was